Battlefield 2042, a video game that was so much hyped up this year alone because a lot of people wanted this game to be going back to Battlefield 4 and Battlefield 3. The hype and the excitement was real until the beta was launched. The game had bugs, glitches, optimization issues, lots of lags, and most importantly, people already started disliking the specialist. And with all that hate and criticism, EA's answer to this issue was, well, it's an older build version of the game. Now that is a very weak answer, but I was a little bit hopeful. Maybe they're gonna change it. Maybe the new version looks a lot better and they've addressed all the situations or all the concerns that the players finally had with the beta as well. Now that the game is out, I can say, none of it mattered. It's the same shit. I was able to play a 10-hour free trial version of Battlefield 2042, which you can actually play as well by getting the EA Play. You can also get EA Play by buying Xbox Game Pass. Now this video is not towards hating Battlefield 2042, it's only my opinion. If some of you guys are loving the game and enjoying it, hell yeah, 10 out of 10 for you. You keep on enjoying and having a great time with a group of your friends, or if you're playing solo, have a fun time. Obviously, Battlefield 2042 is getting thousands and thousands of negative reviews over on Steam right now. I think at one point in time, we'll see overwhelmingly negative, if that was ever a thing. So I'm gonna go with all the issues that I saw and because of why I do not like Battlefield 2042 at the current state. The first one being the main menu. Yes, we're gonna begin with that place. The main menu of the Battlefield 2042 looks shit. I don't know what DICE was thinking, whether they were thinking that this is a more simplest form of main menu according to them, but it's not. It's not a simpler form, does not suit that well, does not look very well. It's not appealing at all. I don't know if they're trying to copy Call of Duty, because Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2019 introduced those vertical columns as menus. I wanted the game menu to be as simple as we have seen in every single other Battlefield games. I do not like the main menu, but if you click on individual modes, I think that menu is a little bit better. Now we're gonna move along straight to the gameplay, and right now the gameplay is not so great. And the reason why is because it lags and has a few weird freeze issues. The lagging is a big problem in this game. The first time I played this game, I had terrible lags. My PC currently has a 3060 RTX GPU with a Ryzen 5 2600 and 16GB of RAM. So in my opinion, it's more than enough to at least run on medium to high settings. But I was not getting anywhere near 60 FPS at higher settings. Not even that, I was not even able to get 60 FPS at the lowest setting. Now that happened in day one, and after a few days, a patch came out from DICE that kind of fixed that issue. But even with that fix and patch that they released, the game is still not amazingly smooth. There are places and instances where the game does drop to 40 or 45, and I'm playing at medium to high setting with 1600 by 900 resolution. It's not even HD. But more importantly, how the game just does not load stuff in the right way. Sometimes you do not see the models loading up. The textures will take time to load. Maybe I don't have the game in my SSD, and that is the reason. But at the same time, hard disks are not that slow that once I get into the game, everything loads up except my character. Sometimes I don't even see a gun, I just see hands, which is not fully textured. So I don't understand how DICE is having a texture loading issue in the game. So hopefully in the future, the game can be more optimized and made a little bit better. Now moving along to the next part, and that is Specialist. That's right, Specialist is one of those hated things that everybody hates, basically. Specialists are basically replacing the class system of Battlefield. The class system of Battlefield usually had an engineer, a salt, a recon, and a support. Now that has been sort of replaced by Specialist. We still have support, recon, assault, and engineer, but there are more characters in the same class. So instead of you picking a class, you're actually picking a character. Now I understand what the emphasis DICE wanted to give. They wanted the characters to mean a lot more, and that makes perfect sense. But the problem is, you use these specialists because of what they come with, what type of gadgets they bring with them. Even though some of the specialist gadgets are very cool, the rest of them does not make any sense. For example, Rao, an Indian specialist whose specialty trait is to hack electronic items. Now, I like that thing, but I don't understand why that will ever be used in a Battlefield game. Why will I be hacking an electronic device in an all-out warfare instead of shooting someone and helping my squad? Most of the time, I use specialists without even understanding what trait they have. However, at the same time, some of the specialist traits are very cool. For example, one guy has an armored shield, and that is a very cool thing to have. If you're trying to kill out a sniper, you can have a shield and then duck underneath and then at the same time aim at the right moment to kill the sniper. For example, the grappling gun is a very good one, a turret is a very good one, but some of the others I do not even consider taking. Maybe replace the specialist and add new traits, or exchange the traits, or make a better trait for those specialists to actually be utilized. And also because of specialists, now everybody can use any type of weapons that they want. If you're an assault guy and you want a sniper, hell yeah, you can do that and get a launcher, why not? You want a C4? Go for it. You want a repair tool? Go for it. And I actually love that part because then it's giving you guys the freedom to select whatever type of weapon you want. You can select anything you want and go into the battlefield. Hardcore Battlefield fans do not like it because they like the class system version of it much more than the open freedom version of it. Moving to the next part, that's going to be vehicles. Now we got much more vehicles in the game, we have more tanks, we have obviously more helicopters, and I for some reason barely see the jets flying around in the map. That's kind of sad. But then we also have a new type of vehicle called hovercraft, which is completely new, and that is the biggest issue of this game right now. Hovercraft is a very fast-paced vehicle, and it's a very, very overpowered vehicle. Right now, DICE is trying to nerf the vehicle and also the weaponry power of it, but at this point, it still is very, very powerful. Because of its movement and it being super fast, you cannot even destroy that thing. The weapon on that is also very, very powerful. So yes, right now, it's way too much. Everything else is fine, but I hate the fact, and I do not know if it's only happening to me. Let me know in the comments if it's happening to you as well. But when I use a launcher to destroy a tank, I somehow cannot destroy it. For some reason, even though it just says that some parts have stopped working for that particular tank, I cannot destroy it, which makes no sense to me. I remember in Battlefield 3 or 4, I can use 3 shots of my launcher and then the tank will be dead or destroyed. But in Battlefield 2042, if I use everything that my launcher has, all of the launcher ammo, that tank is still going. There's not even a little fire on it. And I do not understand why that is happening. Now it could be because of my version of the game or I'm not aiming at the right spaces. But if it's happening to you as well, let me know in the comments below because that is very annoying. And moving along to the last and definitely not the least, the UI of the game. This UI of the game is absolute shit. It's clean and simple, it's shit. And I hate it because there's so many things in the screen right now and I don't want so much of it clustered in the screen. It looks weird, I do not know what to look at. If you take a look at Call of Duty, even they did not change their scoreboard and the UI of it. They kept it simple and kept it the same, just improved a little bit. Battlefield, on the other hand, just completely destroyed that. Now some of the UI systems I kind of like, but some of them I just don't. I feel like they just didn't give much love to the UI. And I wish that DICE could understand this and just bring it back to the simpler form. Why? Why have so much complexity in it? So right now, Battlefield 2042 is definitely not in the right state. I would highly not recommend you buying this game right now. If you have EA Play Pro, you can buy that subscription. You can definitely try this game, but I would probably say to wait a little bit more. I know a lot of people are saying that you should keep hope for Battlefield 2042 because the same thing happened with Battlefield 4. When it launched, it was worse. And you are correct. When Battlefield 4 launched, it was a horrible mess. And later on, the game became one of the best Battlefield games of all time. But the question is, why does DICE have to do this every single Battlefield? Why us players, us consumers, will have to wait another year after the launch for the game to be any good? Obviously, you cannot make a perfect game, but you can at least make a decent game for people to actually enjoy. That was sort of a small rant, but let me know in the comments below what do you think about Battlefield 2042. Do you recommend it? Are you playing it right now? Let me know all of that in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video and liked what I was talking about, then definitely hit that subscribe button because there's more videos just like this coming very soon. More game reviews and much more. Until then, I'll see you guys next time.